Are there any other officers here at Blue Mountain Union School?
No, currently I'm the only officer. We're working on getting more officers, but no one with any proper qualifications has applied yet.
Do you know of any other schools that have your same position?
Currently, none in this area or in the OESU district, but I'm working on getting some at Oxbow.
Good morning, how may I help you?
Hi, I'm Dale Johnson with the documentary crew. I'm here looking for James Kidder. You wouldn't happen to know where he is. I think he goes by Holcock.
Let me take a peek in his schedule. Hi, Grace, it's Josh. Well, it says he should be right there. He is.
What the hell, man?
God, I caught you texting and walking.
Scram. Oh, I didn't see you there. You must be Dale Johnson.
Hi, I'm with the documentary crew. Are you the hall cop?
Yes, sir. I'm James Kidder. One and the only.
So who is that kid you stopped in the hallway this morning?
Let's just call him John Doe. He's a repeated offender. I've caught him multiple times breaking school rules. Someone even called him my nemesis.
Your nemesis?
Yes. He's complained to the school board about me quite a few times. The school board thought that every time he brought up the complaint, it was a joke, and they didn't know that I existed. At least that's what they always say. So the case never took, gladly. I caught him once practicing academic dishonesty. I caught him stealing homework, chemistry homework, out of another student's backpack. He claimed that the student had said that was okay, that they were partners. I didn't think that this was true. You know, I'm a teacher. She doesn't like people working in partnerships. So I reported this to the teacher. She gave him a 0 for the quarter. He missed out on the soccer playoff game.
Oh.
Yep. He was their lead goalie, and he wasn't there. I'm happy to say that he wasn't there, because if you break the rules, then you gotta pay the time.
Well, let's go to my office. Gotta stop and grab a couple things real quick.
I gotta change my mask. You mind stepping by 6 feet?
Thank you. Can you please follow the lines of traffic? Thank you.
The students are lucky to have me. They appreciate and respect my authority and understand the importance of what I do here, keeping these halls safe and running smoothly.
Okay. So, I noticed we're sitting in a janitor's closet.
Yes. Right now, it's not in the budget for me to have my own office, so this was the best that they could work with.
So they let you use the janitor's office?
My office, yes.
Connor, you need to follow the lines of traffic. Right now, you're in the media,
this is,
okay?
No, this is
you
not.
You need to
this
follow the
same
lines
line
of
traffic.
Come on, you
no,
need to follow
need
the lines of traffic.
You need to stop arguing with me right now.
You know I'm right.
You need to respect my authority.
This is... My authority says that this is the right. Now you're going wrong.
Getting okay,
I'm wrong. You know, you're lucky. I don't have any of my citation papers right now.
You know what that means?
He's on the opposite side of the line.
He
is on the opposite side. You know what?
I'll deal with him later.
Teachers frequently call me to their classroom to kind of lay down the law.
What have I told you guys? Bones! I expect if I come back, you'll learn on your phone, okay?
I usually stop about 3 to 5 people a day on a good day. My best days are usually Mondays and Fridays. Wednesdays are kind of like a day off because you know, virtual, I don't have to do anything. So, yeah. Oh, I got a perimeter check at 15. Let's wrap this up.
What's a perimeter check?
Where you walk around the outside of a building, make sure no one's running to their cars, skipping class. Line of traffic, please.
I usually start at the back of the building, just because that's usually where people can go from. It's always high schoolers that are runners. So it's closer for them to go from these back doors out to their vehicles right over there. Yeah, I gotta stop in my locker real quick.
Okay, James, I gotta take a break for a second. I'll meet you out on your patrol, okay?
All right. No.
Dude, what the heck was that?
It's a common prank. Kids are always locking that door.
Don't you think they'd be locking it because they're in there?
You know, a lot of times people will lock it and they won't be in there. Try and keep people from going to the bathroom. Make them, you know, mess themselves. It's a devilish thing.
Right.
Must have learned their lesson last time.
What happened last time?
Long story.
I'm a full-time student right now. I'm in grade 11. It's gonna be a shame when I leave because there's no one that's gonna be able to do this like me. Sorry, I'm just getting a little teared up.
Alright, I gotta go to class, so film around the school, I guess. I'll meet up with you at lunch.
Alright, I'll be getting some B-roll.
Alright.
Hello?
just got a call. They're threatening to release COVID in the school. Someone wants revenge. I'm gonna go talk to my informant. Come on, here we go.
Time's up, yes. Live traffic. Fire emergency. Hold.
He's from another school doing a film documentary. He's fine out there.
Alright, as long as he stays out there.
You won't be able to hear anything if I turn my mic pack all the way down.
Alright, as long as he can't hear us.
We should be good.
What do you need to know?
You see anything suspicious lately? Any suspicious activity?
Well, you know, here at Blue Mountain there's a lot of suspicious activity that goes on, but not much. There was one guy wearing a black sweatshirt that seemed a little sketchy, but it's probably nothing.
Probably nothing, okay. Well, thank you.
Alrighty.
Nothing. It's gotta be John Doe.
He's the only one at this point.
I gotta go find him. Well, let's go.
Ethan Gilden, I need you.
What do you want?
I need to talk to you.
I didn't do anything.
I need to talk to you.
Listen, I've got a different
question. I need to talk to you. I need to talk to you.
Oh my God. I didn't even do anything.
I just need to talk to you.
What is this about?
Don't talk to him.
What are you doing?
Let me have this.
What are you doing?
I need to talk to you.
Get that camera out of my face.
Hey, leave him alone.
You're not even a real cop.
Don't ever question my authority.
Where's the virus?
What are you even talking about?
Where's the virus? Don't play dumb.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Don't play dumb. Where's the virus?
I don't even know what you're talking about.
Fine. And where were you at 9:38 this morning?
Well, after you gave me a hallway violation for texting and walking, I went to my class and I gave a presentation.
Bullcrap. Which teacher was it?
Miss Kane.
Miss Kane. I'm gonna go check. You're gonna stay right here.
Go right ahead.
Mrs. Kane.
Oh, yes?
Was Ethan Gilding here this morning around 9:40 giving a presentation?
Ethan Gilding, yes. He was in my Block 3 SNHU Lit class. And he gave this really great presentation about the allegory of the cave. It was good.
Well, that didn't go as planned. My choice now is to leave. I gotta go to my locker.
Soccer.
I got Ethan off the soccer team. You guys lost by 10. You want him to be gone. You want him gone.
So, it was not John Doe. It was more John Dennis. But I wasn't too far off. John Dennis wanted me gone because I'd gotten John Doe, Ethan Gilding, kicked off the soccer team because of the amount of citations that I wrote him. John Dennis didn't like this because, you know, Ethan Gilding's the head goalie. He's the best in the school. And, you know, because of that, he wasn't able to go to the varsity game. The boys ended up losing by a lot because their secondary goalie just wasn't as good. But sent off the COVID vial to get tested, and right now, I'm everyone's hero.
So, have you gotten the test back?
Yeah, it was negative. Just a bottle of hand sanitizer. But I'm not gonna tell anyone.
Please tell us why you had to hide.